So the biggest question for a lot of people is, how am I going to be an art collector without the capital to collect art? Buying art isn't as singular as buying many things. It's a completely different process. So today we're going to talk about the financial plan that I've put together for you guys to help you guys come up with the capital to collect. That's 100%. Not to assume that you, the person watching this, doesn't have the capital to collect. First of all, there are art on all price levels. Secondly, this is for us to simply go on a collector's journey together, as well as to be a major assistant to someone who is truly trying to figure out, how am I going to save money for my collection? What's going on, guys? I'm Moriah Elise. This is Frame. And if you've been rocking with me for a while now, you know that I talk to you guys about the art market, art culture, and I give my perspective on the art world. If that's something you're into, hit the subscribe button and the like button. And if you have a thought, hit me up in the comments. A lot of you guys hit me up in my DM on Instagram as well. Anyway, I came up with this plan just for YouTube, where we save just a few thousand at a time using a specific strategy for our collection. A strategy that will allow you to save for your collection really without too much thought. Honestly, anyone can do it. It's not intimidating and it's free. Now, if you really want to get into some one-on-one collecting planning or collection planning, hit my email, which is in the description, and we can go from there. Now, look, I really want y'all to do this with me and update me on who you're collecting within this plan. And I'm gonna do the same. Let me give you guys some perspective. My plan involves more than aspects of the question, what do I want to collect or who am I able to collect financially? My specific plan has a strong center around the artists that I want to collect in the early stages of the career, as well as it being the early stages of my collection. Listen, I'm only going to collect what I love, what I have passion for, and what I have connected to. I'm also gonna take quite a look on what their artist has done, the exhibitions they've been in. I'm really, honestly, truly looking at their CV as well. I'm a researcher. I try to make smart financial choices, but I also believe in buying 100% what I love. There's a few artists that I wanna get my hands on, but for the sake of time, let's only talk about one. Their name is Amani Lewis, and I've been watching their work for a while now. The work not only reminds me of inverted colors, that's what they are. And I connect strongly behind the idea of what I believe inverted colors to represent, which is truly to make everything easier on the eyes. And that connection might be rooted in a bit of Black trauma. When I see Imani's pieces and I see Imani inverting the colors and taking aspects of what's hard and putting things that's soft next to them, I completely fell in love with Imani's work. That was my initial connection. So we really only have time to focus on the financial aspect of today. Take a look at how close I am. Other than the pure fact that I purely love their work, we really only have time to focus on a financial aspect today. Take a look at how close I am to collecting my first piece through this specific plan, and also get into who, like I said, is Imani, and get a little bit more into Imani and why I'm considering collecting their work. So this doesn't mean that I'm 100% gonna collect them. This means that I'm leaning in that direction, okay? So as you guys know, we're using the app Acorns to save for our collection. For someone who is a bit astute in stock investing, I would recommend using this same strategy with your active stock portfolio. I have very similar goals through other accounts. This one in particular is for someone who is looking to begin saving with almost no idea how to begin doing it. The main idea is buying assets to buy other assets, buy assets to buy other assets. We're gonna use our stock portfolio and we're gonna use that money to buy art. So if you don't know, Acorns is an app that takes your spare change, rounds it up to the nearest dollar, and invests it into the stock market for you. Not only are we saving our own money, we're building an investment account with Acorns based around their intelligence system that makes investment choices for us based around a plan that we choose within the app. Therefore, we can, of course, increase our value. Or I'm not gonna lie to y'all, there's a little chance of losing a little money, but I've never lost money with Acorns, but the chances there, I have to disclaim y'all. If you want a full breakdown of the plan, visit the link above. Also, click that link in the description to download my link so I can get a little bounce back. I would 100% get a kickback when you sign up with my link, and I need that. I need that. Now, here's a breakdown of where we were when I first told you about my plan, where I am now, and where we need to be before we collect our first piece. So on December 9th, my Acorns account was valued at $2,549.04. On February 2nd, 2021, my account is valued at $3,337.24. That's a $788.20 difference within a 54-day period. I say that's pretty good, especially if we're just saving our spare change. We're on the desktop view of Acorns, and I do quite a bit in this app, but what we're gonna focus on is the invest in your future option. So this page is really great because it gives you a breakdown of how you saved over the last 30 days, how our account has performed, and it also gives us an option to look at our account settings. So for instance, I have my portfolio set to aggressive, and it tells me that an aggressive portfolio is most appropriate for those with longer time horizons, young in age, and a higher risk tolerate. But there are options between conservative and aggressive. I just choose to be really aggressive with everything in life. My roundup settings are set to times two or two times, however you want to say it. You don't have to do a multiplier, but that's just what I'm doing. What that means is you multiply the typical roundup times two. So for instance, if I spend $1.51, and naturally the app will take 49 cents and save it because that's the roundup to the nearest dollar. With my settings, I will multiply 49 cents times two and save that. You could choose a multiplier of 3 or 10 as well. It's totally up to you. The last setting is recurring investment, but you don't have to do this, but I want to add a little bit of a booster to my account. So every Monday I do $50. I really like doing it, honestly, because it helps me grow my account a lot. Eventually I'm going to get over to $100 per week, but I'm not there yet. Let's wait on it. Now our goals are going to be broken down into tiers. When our account hits 6,000, we're going to withdraw 1,000 from that account. I'm personally gonna match it with another amount of money if I have to, but right now we're looking to spend around $2,000. I'm for one gonna match that $1,000 with a different amount of money to purchase the piece, but whatever, it's totally up to you. Again, when my account hits $6,000, we're gonna withdraw $1,000, and that $1,000 is for our art collection. It's, again, it's 100% up to you. $6,000 is cool. If you save $6,000 and you say, I'm not gonna go on Mariah's plan, I'm gonna take my $6,000 and I'm gonna spend it on this art piece, do your thing. That's not up to me. But the plan that I'm giving you is the plan that I'm giving you. $6,000 is an awesome amount to have for a collector's budget for one piece or multiple pieces. But for me, I'm working my collector's goal into other goals. So our goals will go in this order for you guys that don't wanna go back to the other video. When we get to 6,000, we're gonna spend 1,000. When we get 12,000, we're gonna spend 2,000. When we get 18, we're gonna spend 3,000. When we get 25, we're gonna spend 5,000. Okay, rewind that and watch it again if you need to hear that. So keep this in mind. I'm also not in a rush to build my collection. I need time to see lots of art, to research, to think. This is definitely a journey of patience for me. If you guys are in a rush, then maybe this isn't the plan for you, but I allow myself time to do research, to see the art, to get to know the artist. I'm hoping to get in touch with Amani. I don't see anyone that's representing her right now, so I'm hoping that we can correspond maybe on Instagram or via email just to get an indication of like what her prices really are, and if I can actually get my hands on these pieces. It's not easy to find prices, but luckily I had a little bit of insight listening and engaging in a conversation where I heard that her work is in my price range, but I don't know. Who knows, you know? And that's the difficult part. Most artists and most galleries don't have prices on display. I get it, I understand, but as a collector, and as an advisor, it's the difficult part. What I'm looking at is called Negroes and Trees. That's what I have interest in. In particular, I'm looking at Negroes and Trees number 11. I love it, I'm instantly attracted to it. When I really started digging into Amani's work, I was instantly attracted to the series Negroes and Trees. But number 11 has stolen my heart. The medium is a acrylic, pastel, glitter, and digital collage on canvas. It's pretty big in size. It's about 56 by 38, I think. This piece for me has so many different polarities. It's hard with aspects of brick and concrete and wire gate, but it has so many moments of softness, which is the flower bed and her. I feel so connected to this piece that she and the flowers can be so graceful, surrounded by things that are so hard and so heavy. Dude, y'all see how hard this is to get your hand on some work? It's like you're sitting on the edge of your seat trying to get something that's like not available or that may not be available, and you just have to find out. And it's like one of one if they're not selling prints. Go to ImaniLewis.com, go to their website, go to their Instagram, look at their work, read their about, get into Amani Lewis. I love Amani Lewis, and hopefully I can get my hands on Amani's work. I'm currently in the middle of building a house right now with my partner, and really hoping that this could be something we could put on the walls, something that I can talk to her about, that we can talk about with our friends and our families, and get them to collect her as well, because you know that's what I'm about. We're going to collect in groups now. We're going to support these artists now. We're supporting these artists, y'all. Anyway, to wrap it on up, let's hope and pray I'm able to get my hands on this piece, okay? Don't forget to subscribe and let me know in the comments who you're going to collect within this plan. Let me know if you're going to even use the plan. I truly hope that I can get you guys to do this with me. I would love it for us to have a little collector's club on YouTube. Y'all stay safe in these streets. Stay safe out there. Find something you're passionate about and try to love it as much as you can. I hope you guys enjoyed. Love y'all. I'm out.